Welcome back everybody to a new video on the channel. I hope you can hear me all right because I got to sit a little further back for this one. But, and yes, I'm still recording on a cell phone because I'm cheap. I'm going to be showing off the contents of my hiking slash survival slash bug out bag. And just to show you guys what I have so far. My bag of stuff is still a huge work in the process. And so we're gonna start off kind of with our clothing here. And well, I've got tilly hat, boonie hat, whatever you want to call it, and my cat's helping apparently. So boonie hat, sun hat, tilly hat, whatever you want to call it. Got one of those always in there. Thermal socks, very important. Nothing much to say about those.
I then have
a Desert Tactical scarf, also known as your smog, however you pronounce it. And if I'm not pronouncing it right, don't get angry at me. It's an Indian and Middle Eastern thing.
I also have
this. It is a 5'11". Or is it? Hold on here. Yeah, 5'11" tactical combat top. And the cat's helping again. And yeah, it's got like a waterproofing material, anti-sweat kind of thing. I picked that up. Probably not the best color for hiking in the outdoors in because it's black. Move on to lesson three. Watertight Ziploc bags. You can get these at any grocery store, pharmacy, whatever. And these are extra little pouches to store stuff in. And they are from my local army surplus store, from a company in Germany. And they are Tasmanian Tiger. They're just cheap nylon bags. These actually came with my work bag. They are extra clip ends for your bag. I'm not sure if I can use them on this one or not, but yeah, I have those around. An emergency rain poncho. One size fits most. Definitely a necessity, even if you do have a raincoat or a good top like that 5'11". Well, I probably should have started with these, but oh, well, you're not gonna be able to read them because they're backwards. Unless you hold the video up to a mirror. They are bushcraft survival books for trapping, gathering, and cooking. Advanced bushcraft, first aid, bushcraft 101. Oh, there's actually a bookmark in there. And this. This is the Complete Guide to Edible Wild Plants, Department of the U.S. Army, and this covers probably most edible plants around the world. So I picked that up at my local Army surplus store as well. Got a waterproof pen and notepad, which I got for Christmas, and I haven't really had the chance to throw them in there yet. And this is actually a cigarette container that I got at the dollar store when I was really young. But inside it, I have waterproof matches, along with extra striking pad. So those stay in there, and they just stay in the front of my backpack. And then I picked this up at work. It's a headlamp. I got a red. I'm not sure why there's a red light on there. I might look into that. I've also got an Energizer version of a mag light. Nice lightweight. Six AA batteries. Which I paid. Both those things came in a thing at work. And so I figured, you know what? I need a flashlight for my bag anyway. first aid kit. We're gonna open this up and go a little more in depth. And for Canadians, I bought this at Canadian Tire. And inside it actually doubles as a trauma kit and first aid kit, so it's actually got both in here. And well, we've got adhesive wipes, band-aids, traumas. Oh, I do have trauma scissors. Because I really haven't gone through this bag yet. And what did this come off of? Oh, this, I think. Oh, it looks like this is, it only ripped, oh shit. Pardon my language there. Choking, stop bleeding, rescue breathing, choking. CPR on that side. Oh, on the other side, it's just French. I can't speak French. Yes, trauma scissors. Actually, I've added these myself. I'm pretty sure most people know what these are. They are tampons because I've heard they are very good for puncture wounds. All feminine products because of hygiene are very good for that. Precision forceps. Afterbite wipes, a little pencil which actually needs sharpening. First time I've actually gone through here. We have a combine pad. So I got nitrile gloves in here. It's like gauze pads, and that was trauma side of things. And so for anybody wondering, it's like, yeah, feminine products are really good for first aid kits as well. So it's like, just don't have to have many. Just forgive the thumping upstairs if that can actually be heard. I might have a hard time getting all this stuff back in here. But yeah, I suggest Just throw two or three of those things in there and you should be good. Lip balm, sunscreen. Actually, gonna throw the lip balm in here too. I know the sunscreen's not gonna fit. But then there's just the other side's just wound care, so band-aids, skin tack wipes, medical wrap. Most stuff you can find in your pharmacy sections at stores, wherever you are in the world. I've got this I got for Christmas, a pair of binoculars. I actually got the thingy here. They're waterproof. I think the magnification's probably in here too. Power magnification is 10 by 25 millimeters. Lens coating full. Weight. This is 1 pound. Or what it's saying. 1 pound, 1 ounce, 0.5 kilograms. For you Canadian people. I go by pounds, it's just a lot easier. Gloves. Mechanics. Which, these ones are really warm because I had them at work, so I've actually worn holes in the fingers. They're with my hiking bag until I go and get fireproof. Gloves. Plastic canteen. And it's pretty obvious you don't put it over an open flame. But it's a plastic replica of the U.S. Army steel canteens. I picked this up today too. This is my G-Shock Casio, and it is the range man variation for hiking, because I don't do diving. and it is actually solar powered, but because I'm in Canada in January, I ain't got no sun. So, charging this is gonna be an honest to God nightmare, but I'm gonna be using it for work too. I actually picked these up today too. They also have a clear vision and multicam wrap to protect them in. These are actually U.S. Army issue ballistic goggles. And I picked them up for the purpose of work, but they will be going in my hiking bag when I am not working. Due to wind, I picked them up for work due to wind and blowing, whatever's blowing in the wind with all the construction sites I have around work. So they'll be getting used for both hiking and work. Just get into the final tools. Pocket knife. Smith & Wesson, I don't remember the blade length, but it's also got a glass breaker on the tip of it and a seatbelt cutter. So that's always on my person wherever I actually go. So, multi-tool. Pair of pliers. Always have this on hand wherever I go. And this, not on hand wherever I'm going, is my SOG knife. And when I'm out in the bush, hiking, camping, whatever, I've got a paracord wrap around it. And it is a SOG seal pup knife, and this is always on my belt, always on my person somewhere when I am out in the field doing things as quick access for self-defense or cutting or whatever when I'm out in the bush. And last but not least, this, my backpack, which is a zipper stuffer. 5/11 Rush 24. It's a 24-hour bag. I don't remember what the color on this is. I think it's sandstone. And yeah, this is my hiking bag. I may actually upgrade to the 72-hour bag. Maybe. But yeah, this is what I currently use. And no, I'm not sponsored by 5/11 or SOG or any of these companies that I've mentioned. I love their products. 5/11 stuff. I got 5/11 pants, shirts, work boots. I just love the company. They're a very good company. Very durable. Equipment, clothing, whatever you want to call it. Very durable. And I definitely, after this, cannot go to mountain, off like other major brand hiking companies now after having bought a lot of military and police brand equipment, because it's just so much better and so much more durable for the field that I'd rather have that instead of anything else. And no, I'm not being paid by 5/11 to say that. They just, in my opinion, that they have some of the best products that money can buy. One of their boot brands is maybe a little off on the tread, so maybe that could use some work. But I've got their steel toes for work, and they're amazing. But this is a hiking video, so enough about work. And when I bought my goggles, they came with this. It's an anti-fog thing, but I don't have a micro cloth to actually utilize currently. So that's that 5/11 Rush 24-hour bag, and I love my bag. I would not go with any other brand for hiking now, ever. But I think that sums it up, as I am still trying to fill my bag out. I'm gonna get a Zippo lighter, I think. I'm just trying to find a really nice looking one. And I'm looking for a ferro rod. I know my Army Surplus Store has them on their site, but I just haven't been able to get them when I go in, because they haven't had them in the store. But I am trying to get a really good ferro rod. As people have said in their videos, don't buy ferro rods made in China, because they have no magnesium or flint in them, like, pretty much at all. They're almost all steel, so it's so hard to light a fire with them. So I'm trying to get the US made ones, but they're a little difficult to come by. And I've got this for my goggles too, which came with them. It's like a little Velcro carry case. There's still no way I'm gonna be able to put this on my bag, I don't think. But I think when I go out hiking, they're just gonna sit around my neck anyway. Like so. They'll probably just sit here like this. Same at work. Because you know what? I live in Alberta, and we haven't had a lot of snow throughout late 2018 up to now. We've actually had a lot of wind, so. And with all the fields nearby, you get stuff that blows around. You get dust and metal and wood shards from the construction sites that blow around. Something hit me in the eye the other day. I think it might have just been a giant glob of dust. But that's why I bought them. I tried to get a cheaper thing from Mark's Work or Canadian Tire, but I couldn't find anything. So I went with the next best thing, which was U.S. Army issue. And I paid $78 for them, which isn't terrible. But they're going to serve me well, I think, in the future. When I get my watch charged up, this will be on my person at all times, like my pocket knife and my multi-tool. So I just, as soon as I get enough sun, that's pretty much it. I've actually got, and going back to the smog for a minute, I've actually got two. I've got a black one as well, but not gonna use that. And then I've actually got a multitude of hats, and I'll be right back. Sorry about that, I should have got them out earlier, but I've got a multitude of hats. I've got a 511 one. These are Cryptic by Condor. And I've got 4 out of the 5 pattern colors. I got black. I don't remember what color this was. I don't remember what that one's called. But then Highlander, Nomad, I've got this really neat one. It's almost like a watery, mossy stone. I've got a plain green one, greenish brown, same color as mine. I've got a jacket made by this company too. It's a soft shell, and it actually matches my jacket, funnily enough. And then I've got a regular black one. In fact, this was the very first ball cap I actually picked up from my Army Surplus Store and then it just kept going. It's kind of a tradition that I buy a hat almost every time I go. When I go out hiking, I always wear one of these. Because, I don't know, they're great hats, I love them. So it's like I always wear one of those, and I always wear them at work too, but yeah, I gotta get a camera at some point so I can stop sitting on my floor with my cell phone. And well, I know this video probably dragged on just a little too long, coming on 20 minutes here, but I hope you all stick to the end and subscribe to my channel, and I hope to bring you a lot more hiking stuff, related stuff, and equipment and tools this year. It's just, it takes a lot of money because I'm not sponsored by any of these companies, so I don't work the greatest job, so it's harder to drop money now that I'm a homeowner and whatnot, so it's a lot harder for me to go out and get things. But I'm gonna keep adding to my hiking bag to make sure I have everything in there that I need for hiking, outdoor camping, overnights, wilderness survival, the apocalypse, the end of the world, the end of days, whatever. So I'm slowly getting the bag together. It's a slow time coming, but I really want to get more to outdoor survival, hiking, etc. And I was going to post a video from my hike last year in about August, but when me and my dad shared video clips over because of two different phone companies, the video quality just went really grainy, so I haven't been able to get that put together like I'd like to, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to, so maybe I'll get like a, oh, what are they? Oh, a GoPro, that's what they are. And maybe I'll be able to get stuff with that, maybe. Or a camera, a good camera. But thank you for all, if you stayed to the end of the video, like, subscribe. Like, it'd really help the channel out a lot, especially if you want to see more hiking survival stuff. But until then, I will see you guys next time.